Hi, welcome to HowtoDandD. My name is Fred Weller and today I want to talk about Dungeons & Dragons 5e and instant death. In the game of Dungeons & Dragons you have hit points, and when you are reduced to 0 hit points there are a few possible outcomes. One, you are going to fall unconscious and you're in the process of dying, or you simply die outright, you are instantly killed. So how do we figure out if you are instantly killed or suffer instant death? Massive damage can kill you instantly, and to determine this, when damage reduces you to 0 hit points and there is damage left over or remaining, you die if the remaining damage equals or exceeds your hit point maximum. So I'm going to give you an example here so you can see how it works. Right now we have a fighter and a rogue engaged with a frost giant. They're battling and it's the frost giant's turn. The frost giant swings its axe at the rogue, strikes it, and does a total of 18 points of damage. So what happens? We deduct 18 from 9. That comes to, well, it's down to 0, but there's left over, okay? Because it did 19 points of damage, it would go down to negative 9. We don't usually track negatives in 5e, but for the purpose of instant death, we do need to actually figure that out. So you can see the total hit points that the rogue had was 9, and the damage dealt reduced it to 0 hit points, and what was remaining reduced it to the minus value of its total maximum hit points. Say the next strike hits the fighter and it goes down. This time, same sort of thing, it's done 18 points of damage, the frost giant, so you deduct 18 from 12, which means it goes down to 0. There's leftover damage. There are 6 points of damage left over, but that 6 points does not exceed the total maximum hit points of the fighter. Therefore, this character is just dying, but not instantly killed. So if we go back to the rogue again, if the rogue had suffered 20 points of damage, you can see that 20 would reduce it to 0 and put it into negatives of negative 11, which is equal to or greater than the maximum hit points of the rogue in negatives. Therefore, the character dies. That is the simplest way I can explain instant death to you. Once you suffer instant death, you do not make any death-dying saves, and really the only way to get yourself back up and on your feet is a DM fiat, where the DM says yes, you can continue playing for whatever reason. Something like revivify, the spell, raise dead, reincarnate, true resurrection. That's everything I have on instant death for Dungeons & Dragons 5e. If you found this video helpful or informative, please share, like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Make a comment below if you have any questions about instant death, and I will do my best to answer those questions. Until next time, keep rolling those 20s.